Hello, multi marvellous mechanical mouth organs. Ralfy here with Ralfy Review 778, and a big thank you to Jimmy Sandwiches for that mock mention. Sit back, chill out, there's no hurry, turn off your mobile devices, you don't need them, because you're going to spend a few minutes in a mock moment. Provided by myself here in the Manx Bothy, somewhere in the Irish Sea, accompanied by some 16-year-old Mortlach bottled at, out with a steampunker, 43.4% alcohol. Lovely. I can review this Mortlach simply because it's in a 70 centilitre bottle again. There was a while that Diageo were bottling Mortlach in 50 centilitre bottles, which is basically smaller bottles, giving you less product and therefore asking more money for them. In my opinion, it's a bit of a racket. Sure, there are some independent bottlers who are consistent in the use of 50 centilitre bottles to package their wares, and that's the important thing, is they're consistent. You know what to expect. It's not being sprung unexpectedly, as it was with the revamped Mortlach range. So I wasn't buying it, I wasn't reviewing it, I wasn't discussing it until they've put it back into standard bottles, showed a bit more respect to the consumer, as they like to refer to us, the customer, as we like to call ourselves. And now I can buy it. And I must say, as you can see from the fill level, which is the default point of reference that I'm sure experienced malt mates have, I've been enjoying this stuff. Let me tell you about Mortlach. It's pretty damn tasty if you like savoury whiskies. I do. In fact, I'd go further. I would say that anybody with experience with whiskies over time is going to find that gradually you will lose the sweetness in your palate, and as you experience the peaty, smoky moments, you will get used to them, and eventually you won't get bored of them, but you will be looking for other alternative options which provide as much intrinsic experience. And this is where the old savoury style of single malts that you find in Mortlach, also in Benrumach, good example, and Springbank, particularly in the long row. This is where they come to the fore. I must say, I think the 16-year-old, in terms of the quality of the malt for the value of money, for the value for money, is where it is. What I would say, and I'll say it now so I don't forget to say it later, is that this is an official bottling. It's quite, you know, it's got branded bottles going on, you know, with a little kind of spooky decal and a little bit of attention to the shape of the bottle. That's a nice touch. But it is chill filtered. It is got caramel in it, and it's slightly sanitized. In other words, those slightly demanding savory notes have been rounded off for the simple reason it's an official bottling. And therefore, I would suggest that you may enjoy this. But if you pick carefully, you will enjoy the independent bottlings better, because they are more natural and raw versions of the single malt. They're less composed. I'll leave it at that. So what have we got in the nose? What have we got here? Toffee. Raisin. Definitely raisin. That little bit of slightly neutral sherry note. Excuse me, by the way, I don't know if you can hear in the background, but one of my little honeybees has got into the bothy and it's probably getting pished in the fumes. Look at it. It's not a honeybee, it's a bumblebee. Let me tell you something about bumblebees. Bumblebees, is scientifically proven, are too big to fly. True. Their wings aren't big enough to support their weight. So what bumblebees do to make themselves lighter is they vibrate, and that's where you get the buzzing from. When you introduce harmonic resonance, you lighten the weight, and reduce the impact of gravity. Did you know that? The ancients knew that. Anyway, back to whiskey. That's quite enough distraction for one vlog. Slightly earthy, slightly savoury, little bit unrepresentative in the nose. It doesn't really indicate particularly well how pleasant the palate is going to be. So I'll have a wee taste of it raw. Brown sugar, tense, sour, savoury, sweet and sour, savoury, wood rich, tannic, very tannic arrival. Something like peated Bunahabin. And then what you're getting is that little kind of herbal note, spice note, that complex savoury which is unique to Mortlach by virtue of the fact that they're not double distilling. They are distilling, and I'll give you the specific because they mention it because they know it's important. They distill it 2.81 times, so it's not quite triple distilled. Part of there it is, there's the bee buzzing around. Out, out. Get out. Come on, out. Oh, what the hell. As you know, these things are unrehearsed and unscripted. Let's get this done. With Mortlach, it's in the same situation as Springbank. It's 2.something% distilled, so it's not triple distilled. But part of the second distillation, or part of the first distillation, and by the way, there's more permutations than you might realise with this. You know, you can just cut off the, you can just shove in the foreshorts, you can remove the faints, you can recycle part of the faints, you can remove all the foreshorts, you know, you can play about with stills, and funnily enough, that's where the flavours are discovered. And with Mortlach, they discovered this fairly unique and really good quality savoury note that the more sophisticated, experienced palate really enjoys. And this is why they're worth looking out for as independent bottlings, particularly older ones. Some of them are rotten. It's up to you, malt mates, to do your homework to suss out the best from the rest. Right, I've added a drop of water, not that much, on the nose. Bit more melon-like. Baked apple, raisins, definitely. A little bit of sultana, slight mintiness. Slightly phenolic-y, wintergreen, that's what it is, a sort of savoury, slight savoury herbal notes, sage, rosemary. And it's all amplified by the tannins. There's a lot of tannins in this whiskey and a slight sulfury note too, but do you know what? It's fine. It's absolutely fine. What really hasn't helped is the fact that the chill filtered, you know, and just 43.something% to 46%. There's so little in it. There's not much in terms of tax. Why the hell don't they just go for it? Goodness sake. That's a problem with some of the bigger whiskey companies. There's too many offices. There's too many levels. There's too many layers of people trying to stick in with a decision. And they've got to observe this protocol, and it basically becomes too big a beast. That's an opinion. That's more like it. Adding a drop of water really stretches out the whole flavour experience. And that's where this really wins. That's where it really is elevated as a single malt. It's presenting Mortlach very well, actually, although slightly sweetened. It's got that slight stevia note that is purely my opinion. That, you know, a sense from the cask preparation. And that is purely my overview, my opinion, etc. And it's slightly giving this sort of minimal sweetness, which frankly doesn't work. But the length of the arrival, development and finish is greatly extended by adding even a small amount of water. Now I've added What? I'm going to add a bit more, actually. Just a few drops. We're talking one milliliter. More tannins, more tea bags, but very pleasant. It fits in, it suits the malt. They wouldn't suit Auchentoshan, but it suits Mortlach. Baked apple there again. Brown sugar, some rich, creamy vanillas coming through. Those savoury, almost as if they've been, you know, herbs, fresh herbs placed in a barbecue, getting to the slightly smoky stage, acrid smoky stage, sage, rosemary, a little bit of licorice, almost licorice, fennel, that's what I would call it, fennel note. That savoury again, that strong cider, tannin-backed savoury going right into the finish, a little bit of pickle and ginger, a little more savoury, and a little bit of vanilla to conclude. What a delicious single malt. Really enjoying this. Let's malt market it. It's a malt mark. As you know. Really enjoying this. I think it's decent. I'm going to give it 88 out of 100. There we go. That is a malt mark. 88 out of 100. Thank you very much for watching. If you pop back for Ralfy Review 778 Extras, I will introduce you to a non-alcoholic spirit. Yes. Will I say that again, malt mate? I think I probably should, yeah. I'm going to review, straight face now, I'm going to review a non-alcoholic spirit. I hope you'll join me. I guarantee it's going to be entertaining. See you soon, my mates. Bye-bye. Damn B. You out. I don't know whether to switch this off or get rid of that B because it's ready to... I'm going to just get rid of that B. That damn B. I need a container. Oh, here he is. I'll open the... No, I'll switch this off.